Good morning. This is fifth grader Emma. Welcome to Mr. Strau's morning message for today. Take it away, Mr. Strau.
Thanks, Emma. Good morning, COA students and staff. Welcome back to school and a brand new year. Can you believe it's 2020? Did you enjoy your Christmas vacation? I hope you got everything you asked for Christmas, and I hope you're ready for this new year. Today is Tuesday, January 7th, 2020, and we're kicking off our 19th week of school. I'm Mr. Strau with today's morning message.
Mickey, someone's having a birthday.
Oh, boy.
Yep, we have quite a few COA staff birthdays to celebrate. All of these happened over the Christmas vacation break. On December 24th, 5th grade teacher Mr. Frankel celebrated. On December 30th, kindergarten teacher Miss Magwillie celebrated. On January 1st, New Year's Day, Rafferty site manager Mr. Roman celebrated. On January 6th, curriculum coach Miss Strobel celebrated. And today, on January 7th, paraeducator Miss Gliarik celebrates. Happy birthday, everybody!
Begins.
Now that Christmas vacation is over, the countdown begins again to our next school holiday. We now have only 2 weeks to go until it's Martin Luther King Jr. Day, where you'll get a 3-day weekend to celebrate all the accomplishments that Dr. King brought to the United States. Only 9 more school days. You can do 9 school days, right? This Thursday is our next COA school leadership team meeting in the computer lab with me and Mr. Tony. We'll continue learning about leadership skills and continue our work for the next assemblies. We look forward to seeing all the 5th and 6th grade representatives again this Thursday. Well, it's Tuesday again, and that means that we talk about our expected school-wide learning results,
or SLERs,
that are posted in all the classrooms and all around our school. Here's 3rd grader Aileen to tell you all about them.
Hi, I'm Aileen from Ms. Doe's class to tell you all about our school's SLRs at COA. The C stands for creating a collaborative and cooperative community. The O stands for being an outstanding learner and citizen. The A stands for achieving academic excellence.
Thanks, Aileen. Mr. Tony and I will be talking more about these at our character education assemblies every month. And this year, to win one of our character awards, you'll need to show your teachers that you know not only about the character education trait, but also how it fits into our SLRs. But as Mr. Tony always says,
you can, you will, succeed.
The College of the Week program continues here at COA. Each week throughout the school year, we're showcasing many wonderful and different colleges all across the United States. It's always a good thing to start thinking about what college you might want to go to when you're all finished with your high school career. This week we feature Grand Canyon University, as featured in Mrs. Young's second grade classroom. Grand Canyon University is a for-profit private Christian university in Phoenix, Arizona. Based on student enrollment, Grand Canyon University was the largest Christian university in the world, with 70,000 students attending online and 20,000 attending on campus in 2018. Grand Canyon University was established by the Arizona Southern Baptist Convention on August 1, 1949 in Prescott, Arizona, as Grand Canyon College. In 2000, the university ended its affiliation with the Southern Baptist Convention. In 2006, the college spent $150 million to renovate the campus, adding a brick promenade, an aquatic center with pool and hot tub, and a cafe offering an assortment of games and big screen televisions. In 2009, Grand Canyon University's campus began work on a $60 million campus expansion project, which includes a 500-bed dormitory, a 55,000-square-foot fitness and recreation center, a 125-classroom facility, food court and bowling alley, and a 5,000-seat arena. The GCU Arena, which opened on September 2, 2011, is used for concerts, speakers, and other events. The arena is also home to the college's men's and women's basketball teams and women's volleyball games. The arena was expanded to 7,000 seats, with construction beginning in spring 2014 and concluding in August of the same year. Grand Canyon University offers several fast food restaurants, coffee shops, student union, cafeteria, video game room, and a 6-lane bowling alley for student recreation. In August 2016, the university announced it was establishing a campus police department employing a 177-member police force. Grand Canyon University gained widespread attention in August 2016 when it announced its 10-in-2 initiative, the building of 10 on-campus athletic facilities in a 2-year span. Highlights of the project included brand new facilities for the university's soccer, baseball, softball, tennis, and beach volleyball programs. It also included a sports medicine expansion, an equipment room expansion, practice facilities for the basketball and golf programs, and a student-athlete academic center. The university offers various programs through its 9 colleges, including doctoral studies, business, education, fine arts and production, humanities and social sciences, nursing and healthcare professions, science, theology, engineering, and technology. This week, your teachers will show you a short presentation on this college to give you some ideas on what kinds of studies it offers in case you might want to attend.
Hi, this is Angela from Mr. Mensa's class. Here's a Disney history fact for today from Mr. Stroud.
On January 7th, on this day in Disney history. On this day in 2012, Disneyland's Jolly Holiday Bakery Cafe officially opens its doors. The new Mary Poppins themed bakery, located at the top of Main Street, USA, features familiar bakery and coffee items in addition to a new menu of sandwiches and salads. Originally the Plaza Pavilion, the old-style building was used to process Disneyland passes and had an inside-the-park booth for the Disney Vacation Club. After the pavilion closed, an extensive remodeling of Main Street, USA began. When completed, the Jolly Holiday Bakery Cafe had replaced the Blue Ribbon Bakery after its 22 years of service at Disneyland.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with you, girl. A jolly, jolly holiday with you.
Now, please join me in the pledge this morning. Please stand, salute, and pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Have a tremendous Tuesday, and I'll see you again tomorrow morning.
This is second grade David. You've been listening to Mr. Stroud's podcast. See you tomorrow.
Good morning, and may I have your attention, please. My name is Paul Robbins. I anchor the news on TV. I'm mornings on Fox 40 here in Sacramento. It is my privilege to help you start another great school day. And with that in mind, welcome to Mr. Stroud's podcast.
Thanks, Mr. Robbins. Mr. Robbins recently retired from Fox 40 television and is now a professor at William Jessup University in Rockland. Maybe one day you'll be in his college class. Good morning, COA students and staff. Today is Tuesday, January 8th, 2020. I'm Mr. Stroud with today's morning message. COA's new buddy benches have arrived.
Aw, great!
There's a buddy bench located on the playground at each site's building. Here's how the buddy bench system works. The buddy bench operates on 5 simple rules. The first rule is to think about what you're going to do at recess.
Oh, boy!
The second rule is to look around you and see if you can find someone to play with, and then ask them to join your activity.
I can't wait to get started.
The third rule is if you cannot find someone to play with, you sit on the buddy bench and wait to be invited for an activity.
Maybe I'll give it a try.
This rule is important because if you're sitting on the buddy bench and someone invites you to play, you should not tell them no.
Who knows? Could be fun.
2 students can sit on the bench at the same time and invite another person to join their play.
Oh boy, this is gonna be so cool.
The fourth rule encourages future play. For example, if you make new friends using the buddy bench, you're encouraged to play with those new friends again.
Gosh, it's great to see y'all here.
The fifth rule is simply to be caring of others and ask students sitting on the buddy bench to be a part of your play at recess. Remember to check the bench daily to see if someone needs a buddy to play with.
Pretty exciting stuff, huh?
Remember, the buddy bench is not a place just to sit and hang out. It's a place for people to use to help make and keep new friends. So go out and make some new buddies today.
All right, here we go!
Tomorrow is the next COA Student Leadership Team meeting with me and Mr. Tony, all 5th and 6th grade representatives. Grab your lunch and get to the computer lab at 11:30. We'll continue with our leadership skills lessons and our work on the next assemblies. We look forward to seeing you all tomorrow in the computer lab. Don't forget to tune into our school and family radio show, hosted by Mr. Ivan, every Thursday starting at 8 o'clock in the morning on 87.7 FM. They'll share information about what's going on at the school, as well as some tips for being a successful student. Tune in and listen on your way to school.
Hi, I'm Jacob from Miss Story's class, and I have Mr. Stroud's joke of the day. What do you call a pig who knows karate?
I don't know.
Pork chop.
Don't!
The joke of the day.
Hi, this is Ben from Miss Armenta's class. Here's a fun history fact for today from Mr. Stroud.
On January 8th, on this day in 1790, President George Washington delivered the very first State of the Union address in New York City, which was at that time the provisional capital of the newly formed United States. The State of the Union is an annual address presented by the President of the United States to Congress. The address not only reports on the condition of the nation, but also allows the President to outline his legislative agenda, for which he needs the cooperation of Congress, and his national priorities. Also on January the 8th, it's Elvis Presley's birthday. Elvis Presley was an American singer, musician, and actor born on this day in 1935. He is one of the most significant cultural icons of the 20th century, and he's often referred to as the King of Rock and Roll, or simply, the King. Now, please join my friend Paul Robbins in the pledge this morning.
Hello, my name is Paul Robbins. I anchor the morning news on Fox 40. Would you please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance this morning? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Have a wintry Wednesday, and I'll see you again tomorrow morning.
If you don't know why Elvis is called the King of Rock and Roll,
I was living it up, you know, eating hamburgers and drinking Pepsis.
You better get to Memphis.
Hello, Memphis.
This is Elvis Radio, live from the Sirius XM studio at Graceland in Memphis, Tennessee.
Thank you very much.
Elvis Radio at Graceland in Memphis, when guest DJs everywhere like this gentleman. You ready? Go ahead.
Hi, this is elementary school teacher Tim Strau from Sacramento, California, and you're listening to Elvis Radio. Live from Graceland.
Mr. Strauss Podcast.
Good morning. This is third grade Mariana. Welcome to Mr. Strauss' morning message for today. Take it away, Mr. Strauss.
Thanks, Mariana. Aloha, COA students and staff. It's Thursday, January 9th, 2020. I'm Mr. Strau with today's morning message. The Six Flags Read to Succeed program has begun here at COA. Do you want to win a free admission ticket to Six Flags Discovery Kingdom for next summer? It's really easy to do. All you have to do is get a Six Flags Read to Succeed reading log from your teacher. Read for an extra 6 hours,
or 360 minutes,
between now and February 25th. Write down on your log what you read and for how long until you reach that 360 minutes. Have your parents sign it, and then enter your information online using the teacher code and website on your reading log. As long as you have finished it and entered it online by February 25th, you'll win that free ticket. Teachers will not be entering your information this year. Your parents must do so online. All the information is on your Six Flags reading log. It's the Six Flags Read to Succeed program. Every student can win, so go read for that ticket.
Hi, this is Jacob to remind you about this month's character traits of fitness and skill. Fitness means you take care of yourself, eat the right foods, exercise, and keep your mind and body in good shape. Skill means you practice something that you've learned and then become the best you possibly can be when you do it. Show your eagle pride and show your teachers you know all about fitness and skill. Just like our heroes of the month, Olympic gold medalist Wilmer Rudolph and soccer champion Lionel Messi. They do everything they can to keep themselves in top physical shape to compete in their sports, and they practice the skills they've learned to become the best at their sports as they can, which earned them their rewards and recognition. So show your teachers that you know all about fitness and skill all month long, and maybe you will be chosen as the next Character Award winner.
Today is the next COA Student Leadership Team meeting with me and Mr. Tony. All 5th and 6th grade representatives, grab your lunch and get to the computer lab at 11:30. We'll continue with our leadership skills lessons and our work on the next assemblies. We look forward to seeing you all later today in the computer lab. Tomorrow is our next COA Character Education Assemblies in the GCC Theater. Tomorrow we'll see kindergarten, 1st, 2nd, and 5th graders. You'll learn about what our character education traits are for January and who our new Hero of the Month is for those traits and why we chose them. We'll also find out who's been chosen by their teachers to win one of our character awards and be recognized at the assemblies. You'll also get to see our 6th grade student leadership team perform a skit for you to help you learn about our new character education traits. Don't forget to bring your posters from the previous month so we can showcase them on stage. And Mr. Tony and I will see you all tomorrow at the GCC Theater.
Hi, this is Catherine from Miss Meyer's class. Here's a fun history fact for today from Mr. Strauss.
For January 9th, on this day in 1849, the first commercial bank was established in San Francisco, California. The hide and tallow trade that flourished in the early years of the 19th century required no bankers. The Yankee skippers paid cash for their merchandise and kept their merchandise and their money in the ship's strongbox. However, when gold was discovered in California, it caused a huge rush of people to come in hopes of striking it rich by finding gold. This flood of gold-crazed prospectors in late 1848 and early 1849 created a demand for banking. So on this day in 1849, Henry M. Nagley opened the first bank in the city on Portsmouth Square. Now please join third grader Ilya in the pledge this morning.
Hi, my name is Ilya from Miss Ivanov's class. Please join me in the pledge this morning. Please stand, salute, and pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Have a thoroughly exciting Thursday, and I'll see you again tomorrow morning.
Hi, this is second grader Jonathan. You have been listening to Mr. Strauss' podcast. See you tomorrow.
Good morning. This is fourth grader Valerie. Welcome to Mr. Strauss' morning message for today. Take it away, Mr. Strauss.
Thanks, Valerie. Greetings, COA students and staff. Hey, check this out. We made it to our first minimum day Friday of 2020.
Yahoo!
Today is January 10th, 2020, and I'm Mr. Strauss with today's morning message. Coming up next Wednesday night, January 15th, is our annual Family Science Night. Come on out with your family for some fun hands-on science experiments. You might even get to take home a prize. And there's free pizza, too. It all starts at 6 p.m. next Wednesday in Rafferty A's multi-purpose room.
Hi, this is Esther from Miss Meyer's class, and I just wanted to remind everyone to keep bringing those box tops. The box tops help us pay for our field day activities at the end of the school year, as well as other fun things here at school. You can find them on all kinds of products that your parents buy from the store. Each one is worth at least 10 cents, sometimes more. Just cut them out and bring them to your teacher or the front desk of your site. For every 25 box stops you churn in, you get a lollipop too. The more money we bring in throughout the year, the more money our school gets for fun activities, so keep bringing them in.
Today, kindergartners, first graders, second graders, and fifth graders get to come to the GCC Theater for our character education assemblies for January with me, Mr. Tony, and our sixth grade student leadership team. You'll learn about what our character education traits are for January and who our new hero of the month is. You'll also find out if you'll be one recognized at the assembly and win one of our character awards. Don't forget to bring your posters today, and we'll see you all today at the GCC Theater.
Hi, my name is Milana from Miss Ivanov's class. Here is a fun history fact from Mr. Strau.
For January 10th, on this day in 1863, the world's first underground passenger railway system opens in London, England. This underground system has its origins in the Metropolitan Railway. It is now part of the Circle, Hammersmith and City, and Metropolitan Lines. The system's first tunnels were built just below the surface using the cut-and-cover method. Later, smaller, roughly circular tunnels, which gave rise to its nickname, the Tube, were dug through at a deeper level. The system has 270 stations and 250 miles of track. Despite its name, only 45% of the system is underground in tunnels, with much of the network in the outer environments of London being on the surface. In 2016-2017, it carried 1.4 billion passengers, making it the world's 11th busiest metro system. The 11 lines collectively handle approximately 4.8 million passengers every day. Now, here's fourth grader Mary to lead you in the pledge this morning.
Hi, my name is Mary from Mrs. and Barnes class. Please join me in the pledge this morning. Please stand, settle, and pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Excellent! Now let's sing our school song.
We are bright. We don't fight. We will always do what's right. We will love our land and always lend a helping hand in our work, in our play. We stand.
Have a fantastical Friday, and we'll see you back here for school week number 20, the first full week of school for 2020, on Monday, January 13th.
This is sixth grade event. Thanks for listening to Mr. Strout Morning Message. Have a great weekend.